Hey guys, Dr. Josh Axe here along with Dr. Billy DeMoss. Dr. Billy, hey, thanks for joining me here today.
Thanks for having me.
And I brought in Dr. Billy from California. He is an expert when it comes to CBD and cannabis and hemp oil. In fact, he has his own line of hemp oil products. So we're going to talk about the incredible benefits around CBD specifically found in cannabis. Now, Dr. Billy, there's a lot of research now coming out. And a lot of the scientific community and doctors, medical doctors and chiropractors are coming out and saying, we actually now believe that cannabis and CBD have tremendous health benefits. Right. And I know you've even taught, you know, seminars about this, you know, out in California. Talk about, you know, CBD. What are some of the overall general benefits? And then we're going to touch on these 8 different characteristics, but what are some of those things that make CBD so beneficial? And why for so many years has it been actually villainized?
Well, it's been villainized or vilified back since prohibition of marijuana in 1937 because of the fact we've had corporate entities, i.e. the paper industry, DuPont, which was big in paint and varnish. We also had the cotton industry, to some degree, the auto industry and fossil fuel industry all tried to get rid of hemp because it was going to be a viable alternative to, obviously, all those industries. So in their monopolistic ways, they vilified it so that, you know, everybody looked at marijuana as this evil plant that led you to, you know, destroy your life. In reality, it's got so many benefits as far as it's better than papers. I mean, the Declaration of Independence was written on hemp paper.
Wow.
We used it for clothing, fabrics, materials. It's way better than cotton. It doesn't take anywhere near as much processing and chemicals to produce the product. There's even estimates that state that if we used 6% of the available land that we use for agriculture, if we used it for growing hemp, we could totally eliminate our need for fossil fuel. I'd like to see that happen in my, and everything from like, just we're real concerned about the oceans and all the plastic debris in the ocean. I would like to see us use more hemp based plastics where they would be biodegradable and not so conducive to destroying the environment. So that's why it was vilified. That's why people have the stigma about it. Because, again, I try to tell people, dude, it's a plant. Why are we vilifying a plant that God put on the planet that we've used for, you know, we've used it for eons in healing and health, and it's even been used as sacraments in specific religions. And it was just because of a few people with their corporate demands and monopolistic ways wanted to eradicate the use of this plant. But just like everything from, you know, especially things like anxiety and you know, and sleep issues and inflammation, and which, you know, pain and all the things that we see people taking dangerous pharmaceuticals for that have negative side effects. We're actually, and I don't want people to look at it like we're treating this problem with this CBD. I like people to understand that we have a CBD deficiency or cannabinoid deficiency because of the fact. Back in the day, even when George Washington, they made it mandatory that people grew hemp as a food source. And in those days, we got high levels of CBDs in our diet and nutrition. And now we've got to a point where we're all CBD deficient. And that's why we need to supplement with it, not to treat stuff, but allow the body to function at a higher level by providing with what it needs.
Yeah, and we know, listen, I know people watching this video, there's some people that are really pro-cannabis, there's other people that are against it. And listen, this is really about the compound, first off, CBD. And I'll say this, you know what? When used responsibly, especially, you know, plants can be used as medicine. I mean, my entire message is food is medicine. And I really believe there are great clinical studies. In fact, everything we have up on this board, in fact, out of about 3 or 4 others I didn't even put up here, they have medical evidence from clinical journals showing that these have medicinal benefits that are above and beyond and without the side effects used by pharmaceuticals today. And it's funny, the pharmaceutical company is probably the number one company today trying to keep this out of people's hands to a degree, or they're putting laws around it and things like that. So
you know what they're doing too is they're also taking the extracted cannabidiol out of the plant and they're trying to synthesize it.
Yes.
But what they're forgetting and what they don't understand is there's 480 different constituents in the plant, not only the cannabinoids, but there's terpenes, which are essential oils, there's bioflavonoids, there's all these other chemicals that create a synergy, which they call the entourage effect, that you can't segregate. It's just like trying to take a molecule out of a plant, like a carrot, and say, this is going to cure it. Everything in the carrot contributes to the overall synergy and the biological effects and physiologic effects that it has.
I mean, it's a huge thing to say because, you know, I know I'm a bigger proponent of turmeric than just curcumin. I mean, turmeric also has L-tumerone, which increases your body's own stem cell production and works with curcumin, so there's so many benefits. And you mentioned terpenes. I'm a big, huge, you just said essential oils.
Right.
You know, frankincense oil is a prime example. It has terpenes, as alpha pinene, which works to relax the brain the same way some of the very same compounds found that we're talking about here. But let's jump in. So one of the biggest issues is pain. I know you've worked with thousands, and how long have you been practicing?
32 years.
32 years you've been practicing, working with patients. Do you have any examples of patients? Let's talk about these first two, pain and anxiety, where you've seen any type of improvements with patients.
Well, pain, because right now, if you look at the medical model with the huge problem with opiates and opiate addiction and heroin, I mean, literally, if you could get people off opiates and switch them onto something that's going to work almost as well, if not better, and not have the negative side effects, I mean, I'm highly for it. But again, with patients, typically I would just start with chiropractic, working on with chiropractic.
Sure.
And then if I'm having, you know, some residual stuff, then we can apply topical cannabinoids, or we can have them ingest them orally or through sprays and tinctures.
Now, I know you yourself have, you know, I mean, you gave me a product, a rub on a hemp oil product with CBD, and I know that that's some same thing that you give your patients, right?
Right, and the thing is, you don't have to sell it, you just put them on them and let them go, and they'll be back the next time, and if they still have issues, they're gonna buy it because the stuff works so good.
Yeah, so CBD, one of the things that's so incredible about it, and we'll talk about this with some of the other conditions, but it has natural benefits in terms of its ability to reduce pain. The other thing here with anxiety, how about that?
I'm gonna be the first one to say that, because you and I both lead, like, we're
Type A personalities, work hard.
Type A squared, I mean. So my brain would never shut up, so that's the main reason I take it, and it not only helps me with my anxiety, but it helps me with sleep. So, I mean, and I've given it to a lot of people that have sleep issues, and we have great results. I mean, it's hard to measure something like anxiety, so, but as I tell people, if you have anxiety issues, it might be something you want to try versus taking a Xanax or whatever most people do.
Yeah, you know, I was talking to a mom last night who's also a doctor, and she was just telling me, she said, you know what, one of the reasons why she had health issues herself. She was trying to take care of patients. She had all these health issues herself. And she said to me, you know what my biggest problem is? I can't turn it off.
Right. That's my problem,
too. I can't
turn
it off.
Right.
You know, and so I think that that's sometimes people, now most of the time people go and sometimes they'll have a glass of red wine or something like that. You know, there are different ways people turn it off. But in general, you know, there are, again, less side effects here than we're talking about Xanax and a lot of these things people are turning to. So anxiety, absolute benefits there. And very similar in a way, I was reading an article about those compounds. Again, similar to if people have taken lavender essential oil or rosemary oil or frankincense, they have these terpenes, these different compounds that have actually been shown to be, it's called acetylcholine esterase inhibitors that actually drug companies have gone and made synthetic versions to treat everything from seizures and all these other medications with these side effects versus this is the plant-based medicine version. Now, this is a big one.
Let me, before you go on to that
go
one,
ahead.
And the reason they make synthetic forms of the natural occurring molecule is so that they can patent it and then sell it. And then what they'll do is they'll patent it, and then they're going to make all the other stuff illegal, and then this is the only thing you can buy. So, they want complete control and monopolistic ways to promote the same thing that you can do with a plant.
It's unfair. It's unconstitutional. I don't want to get you off track here, it's big. So, cancer. Think about now. This is something near and dear to my heart. My mom was diagnosed with cancer. She's been diagnosed twice: breast cancer, lung cancer. First time she went through conventional treatments, chemotherapy. I mean, I still remember Billy going and seeing my mom's hair fall out. I remember her throwing up in a bucket and just how sick and in chronic pain she was going through all those treatments. And the second time, my mom, you know, even though she was diagnosed as being cancer-free and healthy, she still was sick, diagnosed again. And the next time we used plant-based medicine. We used all natural means, juicing vegetables, bone broth, probiotics, antioxidants, all these things, essential oils to get her healthy. And I think about all the people out there today that are being poisoned and they don't know that food is medicine, herbs are medicine. This is a big one.
Yeah, I mean, the reality is, I try to teach people that we live in an infinite universe that God created, and there's not just one way to heal cancer. It's not just chemo, it's not radiation. And I would rather go a more natural route than using, I mean, look at what cancer does. It kills you literally to try to kill a cancer. So let's work with the body in its own innate potential to heal itself by, you know, like you said, go keto, go, you know, do hyperbaric oxygen, get chiropractic care, do green juices, get plenty of sleep, be happy. I mean, and then also use something like cannabis or CBDs, which is going to affect the endocannabinoid system, which we just recently discovered in 1992. I mean, if you talk to most doctors, they probably don't even know about that system.
Yeah, tell us about that system.
I mean, it's a system that really, if it's balanced, you're going to, it promotes homeostasis in the body. It puts the body into a more healing, almost in a sense, almost in a parasympathetic state where you're going to be able to rebuild itself and create abundant health. And the thing about, we know about cancer, is the CBDs also have this potential through cell apoptosis to kill cancer cells and not kill the healthy cells.
Wow.
So, I mean, to me, I mean, I would rather people take it as a preventative.
Sure.
With everything. Just supply your body with what it's deficient in, so that it lives at a higher level, so you never get anxiety or you never have problems with cognitive decay or I mean, this is another amazing one. And again, you take these small children, whether they're 3 or 4 years old, that have been on, they've been on conventional medicine, and their parents see that they're not improving, and then they go and try something as simple as a breed called Charlotte's Web, which is really super high in CBD, super low in THC, and these kids just get off all medications, they have no more seizures or decrease significantly.
Yeah, so. Yeah. You know, one of the things you said is so important is this parasympathetic, sympathetic balance. I mean, most of us live in that fight or flight state. We're stressed all the time. We're in traffic jams. It's like emergency after emergency. And we need to get in more of that parasympathetic state. You said the sympathetic is that protective state. It's not the healing state. The healing state, parasympathetic, when that is turned on, it's your secretions, it's your digestive juices, it's better digestion, it's better overall function of all of your internal organs for the most part. So this is important. Nausea, you know, I was thinking about a great blend, you know, mixing something like CBD and ginger oil and peppermint oil, great for nausea. Dr. Billy just mentioned Caesars here. Now let's talk about where, so there's a great clinical research now with cognitive function.
And Alzheimer's, which will be huge if it's not already huge. And I think the other end of the perspective or paradigm would be autism.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the thing is, if we can decrease brain inflammation and prevent a lot of these issues from happening. My mom's currently on it. She's 82. She's never taken any prescription meds, and I'm excited to say that. But she's starting to, you know, repeat some things, so I'm getting her on that as a preventative.
Awesome. Good stuff.
And that's another reason I take it. I don't want to be one of the one in two people that's either going to be pre-Alzheimer's or Alzheimer's in the next decade.
Yeah. Food is medicine. It needs to be preventative, as we're talking about. Now, here's a couple last ones here. Diabetes, and there are some great clinical studies on this. And part of the reason is, you know, part of the reason CBD is so powerful at reducing pain and supporting all of these conditions is because of its anti-inflammatory properties. We know most diseases today are inflammatory in nature. Listen, anything with an itis at the end in Latin, that's inflammation. Arthritis, inflammation of your joints. Ulcerative colitis, inflammation of your colon. Heart disease, that's not caused by high cholesterol. The cholesterol is laying down because there's inflammation in your arteries. You've got to reduce inflammation. So in this clinical study recently released, they found that supplementing with CBD oil, that compound in hemp oil, as well, help diabetes patients and patients with heart disease balance out their blood sugar levels. That was a sustainable study done on animals. And another thing here with leaky gut, you know, I get lots of questions. I have a whole program on leaky gut. And we know leaky gut is really at the root cause of conditions like autism, like autoimmune disease, Hashimoto's thyroiditis, and a number of problems. But leaky gut, one of the biggest things I've found in working with thousands of patients with this, it's part of something you mentioned earlier. It's the lack of the parasympathetic nerve system function.
Right.
When your body isn't secreting enough enzymes and digesting, you cannot break down food. So your gut has to take the brunt of all of that, and your small intestine, that gut lining, it can't heal. One of the great things, when you balance out that parasympathetic and sympathetic state, it puts your body in a healing state. Remember this principle, your body heals itself. The food doesn't heal you. It's the foods, herbs, they support your body in doing what it was designed to do. One of the issues with medications, you and I know this, it actually forces your body to do something it doesn't want to do.
Right.
Nutritional supplements, they support your body in healing itself. And so that's one of the great things about using food as medicine, herbs as medicine, is they're supporting the body, they're not altering the function. And so, Dr. Billy, last thing I want to talk about here in topic about this is that there's a lot of controversy, and I don't think a lot of people understand CBD versus THC.
Right.
It's one of the most common questions we get. So can you talk about the properties between the two?
Well, obviously, THC is the one that really
hallucinogenic.
Is used. Yeah, well, it's psychoactive. I wouldn't call it hallucinogenic.
Okay.
You didn't grow up in the 70s.
So. No, I didn't.
Okay, I did. But it's that's the compound that has gives it the negative stigma, is the fact that it's got some psychoactive ingredients, whether it enhances creativity or whatever. But that is also, it's found in the plant, but so is the cannabidiol, which is the active ingredient, which is going to give us all the positive effects. But the reality is you have to have that entourage of effect in whatever tincture or food that you're eating or supplement or dosage, however you want to call mm-hmm. it, that you're taking as a health measure, you have to have a small degree of THC in the product. Mm-hmm. Now, that is to create the entourage of it, but the reality is, and anything that's legal in the United States, because it's legal to have it, it has to be less than 0.3% of the compound. So it has no it would be, the analogy I use with everybody, like a beer is 0.5%.
Like apple cider vinegar or something.
Right, or like a kombucha, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of alcohol in that too.
Yep.
So it has to be there to get the real true effect. But if somebody, like they did the study on seizures in Mexico that just came out, they are actually using straight CBD oil with no THC in it, and they're getting the same exact results. And this is important for somebody that's, say, a truck driver or somebody that works for the government where they do drug testing, because a lot of these products will ping a drug test. And so if you've got that potential, then you need to use a product that has CBD in it oil. I just don't feel it's going to be as effective because you're not getting the full entourage effect of all the chemicals that are in the plant.
Sure. So you know, as we're talking about here, and I just want to be clear on this video, you know, we're talking about the many benefits of CBD oil and using this as a form of natural medicine. You know, and the big thing is, think about this, I think about all the patients I've taken care of over the years, and would I rather them go take a painkiller, or would I rather them do things like CBD and turmeric to support their body in the natural healing state? And that's ultimately what we're coming down to as well, is again, we want to use herbs as medicine, food as medicine, and CBD, all of these clinical studies, look it up for yourself online. We got articles on draxe.com. You can just do Google search on CBD oil benefits, and you're gonna see the incredible benefits of some of these different products. So I wanna say thanks, Dr. Billy, for being here today. We've been talking about CBD and the many benefits. Everybody, hey, thanks for watching.